Trevor the traction engine was happily working in the vicarage orchard. Birds were singing and apples were ripening on the trees. It was a lovely day. "Hello, Trevor," said James. "You look as bright and cheerful as my red paint." "Oh, I am," replied Trevor. "What's that noise?" "It's the bees," called Trevor. "They're all in these boxy things called beehives. I'm taking them to the station. The vicar says his bees make good honey, so he's giving some to his friends." Just then, Boko the diesel engine hummed in. "Take care, you two. Don't make the bees angry. They might sting you." James didn't like being told what to do by a diesel, and he buzzed away. "Goodbye, Trevor," called Boko, and he set off to see Duck at the harbor. Bill and Ben, the tank engine twins, were busily arranging freight cars, but they scampered off when they saw Boko.
"I remember the first time I met those two," laughed Boko. "They nearly made my eyes pop out, but Edward soon put a stop to their games."
"Edward's the only one who can keep Bill and Ben in order," chuckled Duck. "I sometimes call them the bees."
"A good name," said Boko. "They're terrors when they start buzzing around."
Just then, James bustled in. "What's that, Duck? Are you afraid of bees? They're only insects, after all, so don't let that buzzbox diesel tell you different." "His name is Boko, and he didn't. I wouldn't care," interrupted James, "if hundreds were swarming around. I'd just blow smoke and make them buzz off."
"Buzz, buzz, buzz," retorted Duck.
The next day, James arrived at the station to collect his coaches. The passengers were excited and very keen to get on board. The platform was crowded, and the porter was in a very big hurry.
"Mind your backs," he shouted.
Then there was trouble. The beehive fell and broke open. The station cleared like magic. Then James heard a familiar sound. The bees were too cold to be cross, so they buzzed around the fireman hoping that he'd mend their hive. But he didn't understand, and nor did James's driver, so the bees turned to James. His boiler was nice and warm.
"Buzz off! Buzz off!" hissed James.
One bee burnt his foot.
"Ooh! Ow! Ow!"
The bee thought James had burned him on purpose. So it stung James right back on the nose.
"Ah!"
shrieked James. He had had enough. And so had his driver and fireman. They didn't know until too late that they had left all their coaches behind. They tried everything to get rid of the bees. First, they spun on the turntable, but to no avail. They tried washing them off next, but the bees just clung harder to James's warm boiler. Then they tried smoking them off by going through a long tunnel, but no matter what, the bees wouldn't go away.
"It's no good, James," his driver said. "We'll just have to go back to the orchard and fetch another hive."
James's reply was drowned by the sound of buzzing. The vicar was waiting anxiously for James. And when he arrived, the bees flew right into their new home.
"Come on, James," said his driver. "What you need now is a good hose down."
That evening, James was resting in the shed when the vicar came to see him.
"Thank you for saving my bees," he said. "It's a pity it's not Christmas, because then we could call you James the Red-Nosed Engine."
Everyone laughed, even James, but instead, they decided to call James the Bee's Knees, which means they thought he was more important than ever.